Hello friends, so today we're going to discuss this question from LeetCode Weekly Contest 185, Reformat the String. In this question, you are given an alphanumeric string S. The alphanumeric string is a string consisting of only lowercase alphabet, English alphabets and digits. And you have to find a permutation of this string where no two letters is followed by another letter and no two digit is followed by another digit. It means that no two adjacent characters have the same type. Okay, and you have to reformat that string, and if it is impossible, you have to return an empty string. Let's see this with an example. As you see in this example, this is the input string, and we have to first see how many alphabets and how many numbers are there in this string, and then we have to find out an output string in which alphabets and numbers are alternative in alternate orders. No two consecutive characters are of the same type. Okay. So what we can do is, the simple logic here is, we can first characterize out what are alphabet, how many alphabets are there and how many numbers are there, and then we can check whether the number of alphabets and the number of numbers are always equal, or the difference is always equal to 1 or equal to 0. The numbers of 0, the number of alphabets and number of numbers, their size should always be less than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1, sorry. Because if the, let's take the example of this only. So what we can do is, we can make two strings, alpha and num, and our input is a0, b1, c2. So when a comes, we push it in alpha, then comes 0, we push it in 0, nums, then b1, c2. So as you can see, the size of this alpha string and this string is same. So what we can do is, we just print out in alternative manner. So 0, a, 1, b, and then 2, c. Okay, so now also, if there is num 3 also present, so we can also write 3 also here. But if also 4 is present, we cannot write 4, because then 4 will also come, and both the numbers are like side by side and the string is not possible. So that's the main logic. Let's write the code. What we can do is, we make two strings, alpha equal to empty and num equal to empty. Then what we do is, we'll make a for loop, I equal to 0, I less than equal to s dot size I plus plus. Okay, so if s of I is greater than equal to a and s of I is less than equal to z, it means it's a small alphabet, then we just push it in alpha, alpha dot push back s of I, else num dot push back s of I. Now after this, what we do is, we store the size of alpha and the size of nums. Okay, so if what we see this at absolute difference of n minus m is greater than 1, it means it is not possible, so we return minus 1. So we return an empty string. Else what we do is, okay, we always want, if like this has a size of 3 and this has a size of 4, so what we want is, the greater one starts, the first letter of the final string should be the one which has the greater frequency, 0. Okay, so what we do is, we check if alpha, the size of alphabet string, is greater than is greater than num string. So what we do is we swap. Why is this happening? Because we always know that num is smaller than or equal to num. Alpha string is smaller than or equal to num. The string in alpha is always smaller than or equal to 1, because if it's greater, we swap it. So now we store, for storing the final string, we take a string, empty string. We iterate over the original string. And what we do is, if I modulus 2 is equal to 0, because we are doing in parity, answer dot push back nums of I divided by 2, else answer dot push back alpha I divided by 2. And finally we return. That's the logic. Let's run the code. Let's give the right answer. Let's submit it. It's accepted. I hope you understand the logic. If you are still in doubt, please mention down in the comment box. I'll try to rectify it as soon as possible. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.